Hi everyone, welcome to today's video. Today's going to be a really fun video. Are you done? Today's going to be really fun because I'm going to take you around in my day. Now, something that's kind of funny is last time I did this, I was wearing this exact same shirt. And you know what? Thing is, I actually haven't worn it since that day. So yeah, just putting that out there. Today I do have a few things planned. I have a podcast episode that I'm going to be filming for a podcast in Mexico. So that's gonna be pretty cool. And then I'm trying to think of what else I have going on today. Then I'm going to be focusing a little bit on editing a circuits video that I filmed like 2 weekends ago. So the way that this works is that I pretty much always film on the weekends. I'm super busy with work. So typically what will happen is I will film on the weekends and I will try to plan, for example, on Friday or Saturday and then film on Sunday. And then I edit whenever I can throughout the week or the following weekend or, you know, whatever. And I also try not to give myself deadlines. That way I don't burn out. But I really want to get to that today. At least getting the outline done. So we'll do that. And then I have the fun part of the video, which is going to be you're gonna come with me to the store and we're gonna go buy some stuff. I got a bunch of new electronic components. Let me show you. Okay, so I already have a bunch stored and I have some little drawers that I use, but nothing's really labeled. The only thing that are labeled are my resistors because my husband did that for me. So I want to label these and I want to put them away nicely. And you can see it's just a bunch of different components that I got the other day when I had one glass of wine and went shopping. I want to get some more drawers for these to put them away and store them nicely. And I want to organize them, label them, probably not today, but that's what the drawers are for. And then eventually I want to make a video about my components, just a tour of everything that I have going on. So another thing I want to do is go to the electronics store today and just see what cool stuff I find. I love doing that. It's one of my hobbies to just literally go to the electronics stores and hang around and see what I find, what cool stuff is there, what stuff I should just buy and then put away and then not look at until years later when I'm like, oh, you know what would be cool to make? Oh, I do have that already. That's literally the way I operate. So today's video is going to take a lot of editing because since this is a circuits video, there is a lot of background information that I still need to add. All I did was record the actual demos and the circuit clips, but I still need to add in a bunch of stuff for background information, background knowledge, and things regarding all of the math that I did. So what I do when I'm creating one of these is, and excuse my mess on the back, I just saw it. I have to do laundry. Anyway, so as I'm building my circuits for the demo, if something doesn't look right, or if I ended up changing something, whatever it may be, I write it all down on my iPad. So I have everything here. Now all I need to do is come back to it and take a look at the outline I had for the video, what different clips I filmed, and that's how I know how I'm going to piece it all together, as well as whether there's any information here that I need to make sure is included just for completion and for good context, really. Now I have a podcast interview. My dog is scratching himself excessively.
You good? What's going on?
Yes, I have a podcast interview. So I have my lighting set up and my background set up. My room's a mess, so I'm gonna just do it this way. Maybe I'll film a little bit of that. Let's go.
Pues la verdad es que yo creo que sí. Yo he visto un gran cambio.
Bonito día, bye. Okay, we are done with that. That was a little stressful.
It's really hard for me to do interviews in Spanish still because even though I grew up for the beginning part of my life in Mexico, I moved to the US when I was about 7 years old, and then I focused on learning English, and after that English became my primary language, and I didn't really speak Spanish with anybody other than my mom and my dad when I was younger. So even today, my siblings and I speak English. I speak English at work. All my friends and I speak English. So when I started doing these things and these talks in Spanish, speaking Spanish formally in a little bit of a stressful setting was kind of hard for me because I would forget what I wanted to say. Well, not forget what I wanted to say, but more so forget the words of how to say what I wanted to say while I was already halfway through the sentence. And then I'm just kind of like, oh, how do I fix it? Do I start over? What do I do? So practice has been helping a lot. Taking these up more often so that I can get more practice in has been really helpful, although stressful. But it's important for me to share my experiences and to continue sharing, you know, my work, not just with English speaking people, but also people in Latin American countries, because that's really important to me. It's where I'm from. I'm from Mexico. I am Mexican through and through. So it's extremely important for me to share my knowledge and my experience with them as well. So that went well, I think, as good as it was gonna go. And now I'm gonna go to the electronics store. Let's go. As you can see, I love this store. So it was closed for COVID and they recently just reopened in person, but I was shopping with them online because I really wanted to help support them. This store is all electronics. If you're in LA, it's located in Van Nuys. I'll show you inside. Don't worry, I got you. This is what the store looks like. As you can see, it is quite old. However, they have a really good mix of old and new components. They also have a really awesome selection of vintage equipment that is just really, really fun to look at. Look at this laptop. And they also have a really cool old Apple computer. There it is. So I like to come in here and just see what they have. This is my favorite section, which is where they have their different selection of resistors, capacitors, etc. They have pretty much everything that you could possibly ever need, especially for more specialized type of things. I didn't really need anything today, but I really wanted to come and just look around. I like to see what they have. I like to see what's available. And sometimes I do pick up some of these things just to play around with them and see what they do or what I can do with them. I especially like looking at all the different kinds of resistors. Like this one, it kind of looks like an eraser. These are really, really cool too. I really just like to come and look and pick up some things and find awesome things. Like, look at this capacitor. How huge is that? I tried to have a photo shoot in the store. It didn't really go well, so I'm just going to put the pictures here because I'm not going to be posting them anywhere else. I couldn't get the angles right, and I just kept thinking they were going to catch me, so I did an awkward job. Got home. Ugh, I'm all sweaty and sticky. That was a long drive. Just going to let my dogs out. As you can hear, they don't want to be stuck in here anymore. Hi, boys. Excuse me. Good boys. Good boys. Well, I was at the electronics store. I didn't really find much that I needed. Well, I didn't need anything. I have too much already. But anyway, I was only going to get like two little things. Let me show you. I was only going to get these two little things. I mostly went just for fun. I found this board for $1.50 and they were selling it for spare parts, basically. Particularly what I really wanted was this one right here. So I'm gonna solder that off later. I'll show you better when I'm inside because it looks kind of dark. And then I got this, which is just a speaker.
it was too little and I only had a debit card. He said I had to get something else, which is why I decided to get this, just a basic kit for a beginner. And I decided I was going to do a giveaway with it. By the time you see this, the giveaway will be long finished. But if you don't follow me on Instagram, be sure to, because that's where I post most of my giveaways. But yeah, it just comes with a lot of fun stuff. So like some capacitors, some LEDs. Breadboard, with some wires, fun stuff like that. Setting up for a photo shoot. Ooh. That way I can do my giveaway post. Typically I don't do things this last minute, but kind of just felt like it because, you know, why not? All right, I'll show you the final post once I'm done with it. This is what I typically do for thumbnails as well as certain Instagram posts. I just take a video and keep stopping and posing. This helps me just not take so many different pictures. And that was the end result. For desoldering that component I told you guys about, first I needed my safety glasses. Safety first. I put on some music and got to work. I actually find soldering as well as desoldering to be pretty relaxing. Maybe because it gives me something to do without really having to think too hard about it. But I always have a really good time when I do it. Got the part I wanted. Now I'm just cleaning up. I always make a mess when I work on my workbench. Here it is. I'm so tired now. I did so much today and I'm ready to just chill. So I'm going to be reading my book. This book is kind of crazy, but it's really good. And now I'm just going to relax, wash my face, maybe watch a movie. My husband is going out tonight and I'm not. So I kind of just have the rest of the afternoon to chill, do some self-care. And I will see you next time.